Now look, in all this dreary list of your classmates, not one of them seems to have been a real success. I mean, in terms of prosperity, didn't any one of your classmates make any money?
Money ain't everything, missus. That don't buy happiness, you know.
Even so, I mean, surely one of them must have.
Well, they were able. Noah Bendigo's boy, Abel.
Well, did this Abel prosper?
Prosper. They're rolling in at the Bendigo's, missus.
Really? How did this Abel Bendigo make his money?
Well, his father, Noah, he give him his start.
Oh, I see. An inheritance.
That's right. Inheritance.
Yeah, and what did Noah Bendigo bequeath to his son, Abel?
Nothing.
Nothing? But you just said that what Abel inherited from Noah was the foundation of his fortune.
That's how it were.
Well then, what did he inherit?
I'll go tell you. Nothing.
Dennis, we're not going to get anywhere like this.
A huge nothingness. A gaping void. Emptiness. Full of nothingness. That's what Noah left his boy.
I'm sorry, I suppose I'm singularly slow on the uptake, but I failed to
Won it in a game of dummies, Noah did.
What?
Well, he were playing old Saltmarsh's father.
Old Farmer Saltmarsh?
Very fierce dummies players they was.
Oh, you mean it was high-stakes dominoes?
That night down at the Bull, people still speak of it, missus.
Really? It was dramatic, was it?
Two ponies in a van against the hole.
The hole?
Saltmarsh's father had this here hole, you see. Old gravel pit, what got worked out years before.
Oh, I see. And Saltmarsh staked this empty quarry
against Bendigo's caravan and his two ponies. See, the Bendigos was a travelling family before they won the hole, you see.
Oh, I see. And Bendigo won the bet.
Of course, after that, Bendigo, they settled down. I mean, you can't take a hole with you, can you?
Well, quite. I see.
In fact, they lived in that hole for quite a few years, you know.
They lived in the hole?
Yeah, well, that quite a nice grassy bottom, you see, that were free draining, so they just set up the varda down there, and they lived there as long as there was room.
Room? But you said it was a huge hole.
So that were.
Well, I mean, how could they possibly have become short of room in a huge hole?
Well, there were all that stuff building up round them.
Stuff? What stuff?
Well, the stuff what people dump there.
Oh, Dennis, that really is dreadful, isn't it? These litter louts, they're ruining the countryside, dumping junk everywhere without permission.
Oh, missus, you really are quite exceptionally slow on the uptake, aren't you?
Well, I'm sorry, but I get very cross about this.
But Bendigo's charged them.
Charged who?
They charge people to dump this rubbish in this hole.
Oh, I see.
That's why the Bendigos are rolling in it now.
Commercial rubbish.
Rolling in money, they are. Richest family for miles around. Made so much blooming money out of this hole, they bought a nice plot of land alongside it, you see. Built themselves that bungalow up by the side of North End.
Oh, I know the one. I've seen his huge ranch-style bungalow with the pedimented portico.
And they got all them columns along the front and all, and them two huge concrete lions guarding his front gates, and there's always a blaze of colour up the front garden with them plastic geraniums all year round, you know. Cost a fortune, them geraniums done, you know. But Abel say they were investment. He say his missus only had to sort of rinse them every now and then, and they come up good as new, you know.
Yes, and all this conspicuous wealth comes from selling space in the hole his father won from Farmer Saltmarsh at Domino's.
Mind you, Abel's a brilliant businessman, you know. Everything he touched turned to gold.
Oh, really? Give me some examples.
Well, there's his roundabouts and his showman's organ and his traction engine, and that's not a barrel, missus. That's a fowler.
Oh, really? Well, the distinction escapes me.
And he hire him out. And his daughters.
Oh, daughters? He has daughters?
Yeah, the twins.
The twins, really?
Tanya and Lorraine, you know.
I see.
Like as two peas, except Tanya's blonde and Lorraine's brunette, but you can't tell when they've got those helmets on, you know.
Helmets? What does he mean, helmets?
Well, for the banger racing. Everyone know Tanya and Lorraine Bendigo in the banger racing, you know. You must have seen them in their old Eastern Counties double-decker bus going about.
They race in a bus?
No. That's their mobile garage, isn't it, you see? They took all the seats out of the bottom deck and they got a sort of ramp and they drive those bangers in, don't they?
Yeah, what's on the top deck?
Well, they call that their boudoir, you see.
Heavens. boudoir? Racing drivers with a boudoir on a bus?
Mm, yeah, got a dressing table either side. You can see them doing his makeup before a race, you know.
Yeah, well, are they successful banger racers?
Successful? Successful, Miss Youth. When they're in a race, that always one or other of them wins, you know.
Really?
Them Bendigo twins, they don't give anyone half a chance, you know. Fearless they are.
Really?
Fearless.
Scarcely a demure feminine sport, though, is it? Banger racing? I can't imagine the young men finding banger racing twins particularly appealing.
Mr. Safe. Lorraine and Tanya are the most sought-after young ladies this side of Scant.
Really?
Well, you don't often find a couple of nice young girls what can weld their own exhaust manifold, no, now, can you?
Surely not what a young man's looking for, is it?
They are round here, Miss Hooth. Young man round here respect a girl what can whip a sump off soon as look at you.
Really?
Tanya and Lorraine, they can whip round this grease nipples quicker than most girls can slap on this lipstick, you know.
But the domestic arts, Dennis, what about the domestic arts? Cookery? Oh.
You were asking me, can they cook?
Yes.
Can the Bendigo girls cook?
Yes.
Miss Seath, I'm surprised you ain't heard tell of Tanya's spare reaps.
Well, I suppose I had a rather sheltered life.
And Lorraine, she do them pisses.
Pizzas, Dennis, pizzas. I must say, they, one way or another, they do sound a very striking couple of young ladies in every way.
Biggest catch round here for a couple of lucky fellas, you know. Marvellous wives they'd make. And of course, whoever gets Lorraine and Tanya.
Yes.
Well, you can guess for yourself, can't you?
No.
Well, Abel Bendigo's this dad.
Yes.
And he ain't got no sons, do he?
So?
So whoever gets Lorraine or Tanya gets the share of the whole.